Hey, monkey.
Or should I say, Sir Simeon? Yeah, that's right. I have to find, in Emily's own words, a dozen little critters. First, I'm gonna call Sally McDonald because, five, three, eight, nine. Because what better way to start off a stream than a phone call?
Hello?
Hey, Sally, it's Nancy.
Nancy, hi, how's it going?
Oh, well, I guess I don't have anything to talk about. Never mind.
Talk to you later.
Stay in touch.
Yeah, okay. Well, never mind. Now, I think I collected some before I ended off my stream last week. Yeah, I have two worms. So, I only found, I found two. Now I just need to find 10 more. Now, I mentioned this last stream, but when you're looking for critters, what you want to do is listen for chirping. Like that, see? Alright. 3 down, 9 to go. Jesus H. Crisps. So how are you doing, Sir Simeon? How's life been treating you? Okay, I already looked under there. Okay, found my way back to the... Oh, whoopsies, I didn't mean to grab that. I'm looking for... my map. When I played this game as a youngin', I realized that I would repeatedly look underneath the same rock, like so many times, and not even realize it, and I just would not make any progress whatsoever. Well, I'm good at finding my way out of the forest, that's for sure. Not exactly sure what the purpose of being able to observe the stone pillar was. Oh, and now, what? Okay, not that one. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I need 5 more. Yeah, it's been really warm here the past few days as well, so, I'm trying to find my way to the cemetery because I think there's some bugs there too. Okay, so I'm gonna go this way. Fallen tree. So I'm gonna go this way. Then there's a log. I'm gonna go that way. Yellow ribbon. So I'm gonna go this way. Bugs that I'm looking for are here during the night. Alright, well, I'm just plumb getting myself lost. Okay. Fallen tree. Log. There we go. Okay, now I have to go to sleep and I have to come back out when it's nighttime because, yeah. Because some bugs you can only find at night. Okay, so there's none there. I'm guessing they're all gonna be in the woods. Well, we have really cold winters where I live. None there. None there either. Two, three, five, six, seven, 10. I think I counted that right. Yeah, so I just need 2 more, and I think I know where to find them. Okay. goblins are pretty scary at night. Okay, so now. So I'm gonna go this way. It's hard to navigate the woods because they're always, they look the same. Okay. Bog. I can hear a little like beeping or honking or something. Alright, I think that's 12. Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Did it! The yellow bugs are glowing. Haven't you ever heard of glow worms? I need to go this way. Or, no, I guess I go the other way. So I'm at the fallen tree. Getting myself turned around. There we go. That's better. Oh. It's the sound of the ghost dogs. Well, just gonna go to sleep, wake up. Yeah, well, I think even, like, fireflies, their eggs glow, and, like, they even glow as, like, larvae. Alright, let's go to M's Emporium, give her a dozen little critters, and get that camo.
Nancy, how's the bait finding coming along?
12 big, fat, juicy ones, just like you wanted.
Well now, you done all right for a city gal. Here you go. Hope whatever you're hiding from won't catch you. How you holding up?
Any word from Tucker what's-his-name? He hasn't been by to move that tree yet.
I'll give him another call. But like I said, the man marches to the beat of another drummer. A very slow drummer.
Yeah. I'm sure we all know someone like that.
Guess I'll see you later.
I guess you will.
I like this sign right here. I'd like to have that in my room. Let's go to the ranger station to see if, got that water sample back. I almost forgot about that. Yeah, you said it right just as I... Hello, look at this. It's a doggy! The sheriff has a doggy.
You're back.
Have you gotten the results back from that water sample I left with you?
I meant to call the Department of Health today for a status report, but frankly, I've been way too busy.
Sounds like Moon Lake could use 2 rangers.
If I were in charge of just 10 more acres of parkland, they'd give me an assistant, and I could devote more time to the acquisition of more land and eventually put Moon Lake on the map as one of the biggest, most popular parks in the state.
Sounds like a motive for wanting to get rid of Sally.
Why didn't the Parks Department buy the Malone property instead of Sally?
She outbid them, the cheapskates.
Well, if those dogs scare Sally away for good, other people are bound to think twice about buying the place. The bank will lower its price, and you'll have your land.
You're insinuating things again, Miss Drew.
You notice, on his character model, his, the color of the... of his skin on the palms of his hands is lighter than the rest of his skin. I think that's a really cool detail because that's how skin works in real life too.
I'm sorry, I really am. It's just that Sally's my friend and I'd really like to find out why someone's doing this to her.
Tell you what, if you're serious about making amends, there's some boxes by the computer labeled with dates. They're from the estate of a local history buff. She kept everything from newspaper clippings to old photos to recipes for apple crisp. She put everything in envelopes, then numbered them by year using Roman numerals. Just put the envelopes in order by year with the earliest date in front. Oh, and if you're rusty on Roman numerals, there's an entry on them in the computer.
I hope I don't get distracted. Apple crisp sounds good right now.
Don't go reading anything until you're through, or take my word for it, you'll never get finished.
Right, okay. I'm not good at that puzzle. I am terrible with Roman numerals. I mean, I had a VHS collection of The Land Before Time growing up, and they number those movies by using Roman numerals. I never knew what kind of dog... the ranger's dog was.
I've been trying to take pictures of birds for this guy named Red Knot. Ever met him?
Oh yes, the bird man. I'd stay away from him if I were you.
Why? Is something wrong with him?
He's a fanatic. He's got it in his head that Moon Lake would be the best birdwatching venue in the world except for one thing. Too many people. Believe me, if there was a way to get this park shut down and all the homes on the lake torn down, he'd do it in an instant.
I fully believe that. It honestly sounds to me like Red Knot... It honestly sounds to me like nobody really likes him, which, you know, is fitting considering that he doesn't really seem to like anybody.
I'll be right back.
Dances to DK rap. Yeah, putting a ton of blame on just one person does sound kind of suspicious.
I noticed you have a dog.
That's Yogi, who never goes out unless he's on a leash. Park rules.
Oh, gosh. People are not wrong about Ranger Acres being a stickler for the rules. It's like, of course you're gonna follow the rules for your own dog.
Do you have any other dogs?
I hope you're not suggesting I trained Yogi to run around in the middle of the night barking and attacking houses.
Well, of course not. Well, even if it was him, it wasn't Yogi because, like, He doesn't look anything like those dogs. Those dogs are Rottweilers, and Yogi is clearly not a Rottweiler.
Thanks for all your help.
That's why I'm here.
Have you ever met a Rottweiler? They are very intimidating looking dogs, but they are, well, I've only ever come into contact with probably one Rottweiler in my life, and he was pretty nice. Ooh, these are pretty. I'm probably gonna take Ranger Acre's advice and look at the computer for, Roman numeral shit. History. Early settlers. No, okay. Roman numerals, okay. 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 It says '19 is XIX. Okay, remember that so that way I'll know years and stuff like that. 49 is XLIX.
Let's see. Jeff said the envelope with the earliest date goes down in the front of each box.
Okay. The envelope with the earliest date goes down in the front of each box. Okay, so that one is correct. So that's so this is 1910. MCM VIII. Okay, so if this is 1908 and this is 1910. So, these two need to switch places. MCM IV. That's 1904. Okay, this one is 1904. And this one, it said it was... Okay, 1900... 08. Yeah, 1910. MCMXI. So that's 1911. So yeah, I think these are all in the right place. Yeah. If not, I can just come back and fix it. Okay. So, MCM X III. Okay, so that one is in the right place. MCMXIV. Yeah, so that one is also in the right place. MCMLX. Oof, that one is, that one would probably go right there. So MCM X. CV. II. That's 1997. All right, yeah. Looks like I did organize the first row correctly. I organized it correctly. Because I'm checking this guide that I have, and yeah, I ordered it correctly. I'm eating Velveeta shells and cheese. I started my period yesterday, so I'm getting a craving for carbs. I don't know. For me personally, it makes sense for a history buff to want to use Roman numerals, because obvious is obvious. I think this one goes here. Yeah. MCMXXV. Where is that? Okay. That goes right here. Where is that one? I'm looking for MCMXCVII.
Now that they're all sorted, I can do some reading.
Alright. Sorry that took a while. I'm gonna take a bite of my pasta. Yeah, sorry that took a while. Also, sorry I looked up the answer. I just don't want to waste my time with this. Michael Mickey Malone died yesterday of liver failure in the federal penitentiary of Leavenworth, Kansas at the age of 52. Okay, yeah, that's the gangster who owned the house that Sally lives in now. Well, it's just a fictional person. You don't need to be so mad about it. Hey, look, it's Emily Griffin. I think I already looked at this one, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Gangster. Mickey Malone in pajamas being led away. Oh man, that photography looks legit. That would be historic. Agent Waldo Matthias. I find it funny how you do so much organizing and so much whatever, but you can only read like a few of these. All right, well, we can go tell Jeff Akers that
you're back.
We organized it.
I finished putting all those envelopes in order.
Excellent. Thank you, Miss Drew. And to show my gratitude, I've got something for you.
It doesn't involve Roman numerals, does it?
No, it's an honorary Junior Park Ranger pin. I keep them on hand so I can give them out to children whom I see demonstrating respect for park rules and regulations. A little bit of positive reinforcement.
That's nice.
Unfortunately, I don't get to give them out that often.
Oh, gee, thanks, Ranger Akers. Thanks for all your help.
Not a problem.
It's sad that he doesn't get to give them out often. I mean, he may be a stickler for the rule, for following the rules, but you can't say that he's not good at his job. It's nice that he has passion. It's nice that he likes what he does, you know? I mean, I can respect that he likes what he does. The last thing we need is someone who just, you know, is stuck in a job that they hate. All right. Now we can go and take pictures of those birds. So let's get to that fallen tree, and I think I have to, I'm gonna go to where I find the red bird. I mean the yellow bird, sorry. What the fuck am I even talking about anymore? I don't know. I don't know anything. I don't function. Oh, another log. Okay, I'm not seeing the yellow bird anywhere. Birds chirping, but I can't find no birds. Okay, I just walked myself straight out of the forest. Now let's try to go this way. Cardinal. I'm not seeing the birds anywhere. Oh. Yeah. I'm not. Oh, oopsies. I was trying to scratch myself. Then I just wound up hitting my microphone. Yeah, I'm gonna try to... I'm gonna call Bess and see if they have any... See if she and George have anything to talk about.
Hello?
Bess, it's Nancy.
I know that. What's going on?
Moon Lake is gorgeous, but it's so remote. The park ranger is the closest thing they have to a sheriff around here.
Park ranger? What's he like? Which, as we all know, is Bess's way of saying, park ranger? Is he cute?
Not true, George. Nancy thinks everybody's cute, so what would be the point? Anyway, Nancy, you were saying?
No, that is absolutely code for, is he cute?
His name's Jeff Akers. He's very helpful, polite, efficient, knowledgeable.
Sounds boring.
In fact, he probably knows more about the area than all the other residents of Moon Lake combined.
Sounds very boring.
What's he know about these alleged ghost dogs?
He thinks they're just plain old dogs that for some reason like to run around at night scaring people.
And what does Detective Drew think about the dogs?
I think Sally had good reason to be scared of them. I don't blame her for leaving. Which leads me to think that maybe that was the whole idea.
Somebody had those dogs attack Sally in order to scare her away?
Why would anybody do that? She was there for less than a month.
You'd have to be a total creep to make enemies that fast. And Sally's one of the nicest people I know.
Ooh, Nancy! Speaking of cute guys, Frank and Joe Hardy called. I filled them in on where you are and what you're doing, and they're dying to hear from you.
Oh, yeah? What are they up to?
Compared to you, nothing. As I was telling them about this latest case of yours, I could hear them turning green with envy right through the receiver.
Their number is 280-555-4865. Bess didn't recognize it when they called and almost didn't answer the phone.
Good thing my cousin here has a memory like an elephant, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
Call them, Nancy. They're dying to hear from you. But remember, Frank's cute and all that, but George and I want to hear from you, too.
Yeah, no fair discussing the case with them from now on and not with us. Promise you'll keep us up to speed?
I promise.
I love Nancy's friends. Nancy sure makes friends with very, very quirky people.
Get this. It turns out that Jeff Akers will be one happy park ranger if Sally sells her Moon Lake property back to the bank and they wind up selling it to the Parks Department.
You think he might be responsible for all this ghost dog stuff?
He has a motive and he has a dog, although it doesn't look at all like the dogs that have been scaring Sally.
But it shows he knows something about dogs. Better pull out your suspect list and pencil him in, Nan.
I still say you guys should lighten up on him.
Thanks, Bess.
You two would get a kick out of the woman who owns this little store on Moon Lake.
How so?
She's a real country gal. We got this deal worked out where if I need something she carries, she'll let me do little chores to pay for it.
What kind of little chores?
Oh, like collecting bugs and worms so she can sell them to fishermen as bait.
Sounds delightful.
Well, you know Nancy. She's not afraid to get her hands dirty.
She also makes money selling antiques from the 1920s that she finds in Moon Lake.
Sounds like an enterprising woman.
Ranger Akers thinks she's getting them illegally.
Ah, an enterprising crook.
Dragging the lake to recover objects is against the law. He thinks she does it anyway, and that her favorite spot is in front of Sally's.
You know what that means.
It means Emily Griffin has made my suspect list.
Because if she is breaking the law, she'd want the Malone house to stay empty so she can keep dragging the lake without anybody seeing her.
It does sound like a viable motive, but not interesting enough to, you know, be a motive to want to scare someone off of a property. Oh yeah, not just the modern world. I'm pretty sure, historically speaking, even now, like, a lot of courts will actually, there are courts where if the perpetrator is attractive, then the system will give them a less harsh sentence.
Did I mention that all the water in Sally's house comes from a well?
Ew, really? Does it taste like rotten eggs?
Not all well water tastes like rotten eggs, Bess.
I don't know if it does or not, because the well is so old, I need to get the water tested before I drink it.
Good plan. Nothing will wreck your day faster than a nice tall glass of contaminated water.
Among other things. Yeah. God, what was I gonna say? Oh, yeah. I actually have watched videos of people asking people, out of these two guys, who would you trust? And one of them is, you know, what a bigot would think that a typical terrorist would look like, you know, wearing a turban, has a long beard, and they're obviously not white, so, you know. And then the other picture is of a serial killer, specifically Ted Bundy, and we all know what Ted Bundy did, and if not, I highly recommend that you research it, and then promptly go cuddle a teddy bear, because, oh my gosh, he was such a horrible person, but he was so good at faking being friendly and charming. He was very charming, charismatic, and he acted very kind and amazing to other people, and that's why one of the biggest reasons why nobody suspected that it was him. And it really speaks volumes about our society, about how, like, oh, that person doesn't look trustworthy because of the prejudices and the biases that are built into me, like the skin color says it all, or the fact that they're wearing a scarf on their head says it all, or the fact that they've got this long beard says it all. But that person over there who's got this charming smile, this good charisma about them, they're totally trustworthy. They don't look at all like a shifty, crooked menace. No. Yeah, no, it is not cut and dry. You would not believe their reactions when the people, like, so many of the people said that they, just based off of the photos of the two images, most of them said, like, I would trust this guy over this guy, and the person that they said they would trust was Ted Bundy. Now, obviously, most of them did not know that that was Ted Bundy. They were just shown two pictures of two people, and they decided that he looked more trustworthy than the Sikh guy who had a turban on and had a long beard. No, I was just talking about how appearances aren't everything, and people
you can't just base your who you trust off of like who you trust just based off of looks. Like, oh, that person looks like a terrorist, so I'm not gonna trust them. But this person who's got a charming, charismatic personality is totally not gonna hurt me.
This birdwatcher I met has got me taking pictures of birds for some survey he's doing. He's a bit of a grump.
Does he live nearby?
No, he just kind of hangs out in the woods. In fact, I only see him at night.
Interesting. He's in the woods at night. The dogs are in the woods at night. Could he have had a reason for wanting Sally out of the Malone house?
I said,
maybe.
Dreamer.
From what Ranger Akers told me, Red would like everybody around here out of their houses. He thinks there's too many people at Moon Lake and it's ruining the bird watching. Ranger Akers called him a fanatic.
Fanatic equals suspect in my book.
Honestly, anything can be a motive.
Bye, you guys.
Don't be a stranger. Take care.
Yeah. Well, I don't always refuse to trust nice people because sometimes it is that way where the nice people are genuinely nice, although that's apparently in rare form these days. And sometimes the menacing, shifty person is genuinely a menacing and shifty person, but like I said, it's, you can't tell just based off of looks. So yeah. Okay, 1-2-8-0-5-5-5-4-8-6-5. I love talking to the Hardy Boys. The Hardy Boys are probably my favorite characters in the Nancy Drew series.
Hello?
It's Nancy.
Nancy, how's it going? No, wait. About the weather or something.
The weather?
Yeah. Give me time to grab the other one and take it outside. Frank's washing the car. He'll kill me if he misses anything. Here, wait.
It's funny because my personality is the opposite of always.
He's putting the hose down. He's drying his hands. He's walking over. Nancy, hi! What's up? Bess and George say you've got another mystery on your hands. Or should we say, on your paws.
They told you about the dogs?
We made them tell us everything. Pumped them dry. As you may have guessed, we're not exactly rolling
in
detective
tulip.
Work here.
So you're living vicariously through me.
It's not the first time, sad to say. What conclusions have you reached so far, detective?
If nothing else, those ghost dogs are very well trained. I'm watching to see who owns and or trains dogs around here.
Good plan. But don't forget, a really smart perpetrator is going to make it look like he or she has no connection to dogs whatsoever. But then a really, really smart perp might have dogs all over the place and not bother to hide it, because he or she would figure you'd never suspect anyone so obvious.
Those are both very, very valid points because, yeah, obviously you want to make yourself look like the least likely person to be the perpetrator because... obviously, it's never going to be, whenever, in a mystery or a horror or a thriller or whatever, it is almost never the most obvious person because there's no excitement in that. There's no drama. There's no none of that.
Emily Griffin doesn't seem to have any dogs.
Uh-oh. Move her up on your suspect list. I'd move her down. You know, Joe, something tells me we're not helping.
Oh my gosh, that's so funny.
Malone and his four dogs are supposedly buried in a little cemetery near the house. They've all got headstones inscribed with when they were born and when they died.
That's interesting. Did Malone have family?
Not that I'm aware of.
Then who had the tombstones inscribed?
That's exactly what I was wondering.
Sounds
it,
like this
does pose
of
a mystery.
Yours is still missing a few pieces.
Definitely.
I seem to be getting nowhere fast. Anybody have any suggestions?
We can probably come up with a few, but we're not going to make it easy for you. After all, it's your case, not ours. No sleeping in for you until you get those bird pictures taken.
Later, guys.
See ya.
Okay, yeah. So I'm just gonna go upstairs and sleep. I'm gonna do the PM one, but then I'm gonna go back up and then I'm gonna do AM. So now it's early, first thing in the morning, first thing I'm gonna do, go out into the woods and take some pictures of some damn birds. Yeah, because remember, Red Knot said we should try early in the morning when all the birds are out. That's like the whole meme, isn't it? Where it's like the backyard Tweety wakes you up at 5 a.m. birds. You know how there are some people who actually... I just heard a bird. You know how there are, like, people who are afraid of birds? Have you guys ever met anybody who's afraid of birds? I have a freaking song stuck in my head right now. It's this way. Oh. Found a robin. Alright, I just need two more bird pictures. What you want is what you're gonna get. I'm not waiting for you to figure out what you've done to cross me through. I don't think that you understand. You've fallen under the spiral of determination, and you don't regret. Your aunt is afraid of cats. A gladiolus. Oh yeah, I've heard of a gladiolus. Isn't that like a... I think it's also called a sword lily. Yeah, so the last bird we have to find to take a picture of is the red-tailed hawk. But I think after wandering around enough times, Nancy's going to make a dialogue about how there are no red-tailed hawks anywhere around, and then you have to go to Red Knot and ask him for advice about that, and that will trigger more of the plot of the story.
Nope, no hawks.
Yeah. I don't think I've, well, I mean, maybe I did in a zoo, I don't remember. Maybe that was an eagle. Yeah. In the zoo in the town where I live, there's a golden eagle named Goldie who was rescued and is cared for at the zoo. She was shot by hunters. Yeah, snakes are a pretty common fear. You know what else is a really common but extremely irrational fear? Sharks.
How's the bird watching coming along?
I just can't seem to find a red-tailed hawk. Any suggestions?
Well, there's gotta be lots around here. You haven't been going around wearing sunglasses and earmuffs, have you?
Where am I most likely to see one?
Well, according to my bird map, they like to nest in the big tree that's just to the southwest of the Malone house. I suggest you park yourself nearby and wait. Bound to spot one sooner or later.
See you in a while.
No hurry.
Yeah, okay, so you're supposed to, talk to him about that, and then you're supposed to go upstairs, go back to sleep. Man, Nancy sure does a lot of sleeping in this game. So, I think real quick, before I do that red-tailed hawk thing, I want to go over to the ranger station and see if the water sample is back. Oopsies. Before I go real quick. I'm just gonna put this right here. Let's go see. No, the life jacket is just permanently in my inventory. I think once you pick it up, it's just permanently in your inventory, so you don't have to worry about it.
You're back.
Where's Yogi?
In the run out back. Even out of sight, he's under my full control, as park rules require.
You're such a fucking nerd.
Sorry to bother you again, but did those results from the water test come in yet?
There's something here for you from the State Department of Health.
All right.
Oh my gosh, not only is the water bad, but it seems like the well may have been contaminated deliberately.
Uh-oh. Initial tests found high levels of arsenic in the sample you sent us. While it is not unusual to find trace amounts of arsenic in wells in your area, the amount in your sample far exceeded standard safety limits. Therefore, the water in your well is unsafe for any purpose. Further tests have been requested. They will take 2 weeks to complete. You will be informed as to what, if anything, they uncover. Ooh, yeah. So, Sally's well water has arsenic in it, which is obviously really bad, so definitely don't want to be drinking that.
I wouldn't go jumping to conclusions without proof, Ms. Drew. I'm sure there's a far less melodramatic explanation.
Well, considering that she also has a bunch of ghost dogs trying to scare her off of her property, it does feel a little too convenient.
Thanks for all your help.
Always a pleasure.
All right. Poison ivy. Alright. Well, time to go back and look for that red-tailed hawk. So yeah, definitely don't want to be drinking that. I'll be right back. Yeah, somehow I don't think that they did. Oopsies. I need to stop abusing my microphone.
I don't think this is the tree Red was talking about.
No.
Well, I don't see any hawks, but this is probably the tree Red was talking about. At least it was the tree. That sounded like a hawk.
Look! Got them all.
Hey, what is that hawk standing on? Oh, that looks like a speaker.
What? Oh! What the heck?
Huh?
Fire!
I better get out of here.
Uh-oh.
My arms and legs are tied. I can't move.
Uh-oh.
At least I can kick. If I could just get that scythe down, I could use the blade to cut the rope around my wrists and free my hands.
Okay, so what you gotta do a very specific Chain of events. Okay, yeah, no. You have to kick. Did I do it wrong? Oh, crap. Yeah, I think I did it wrong. I'm panicking. Uh-oh. Okay, yeah. Try that again, okay? So, I'm going to do that. I'm gonna do this. Okay, yeah, that's what I was supposed to do. Yeah, sorry, haven't played this game in a long time. Okay.
I can't just let this thing burn up. I've gotta put it out.
Okay, ah, my mouse is not cooperating with me. Okay. Oh, crap. Okay. Gotta hurry. Gotta get some water. Okay, yeah. Come on.
Phew. What in blazes happened? I saw the fire from my platform and came running. You weren't in there playing with matches, were you?
I was looking at birds, and then I noticed something on the house, and the next thing I knew, I was locked in the tool shed and somebody was setting it on fire.
Whoa, you're not making much sense. Probably smoke inhalation or something. Come talk to me after you've cleaned yourself up and gotten some sleep. I need to tell you something.
Somebody tried to kill you?
I didn't say that.
Somebody knocked you out. Locked you in a shed, set it on fire, and you think they were, what, just pulling a prank? Wake up and smell the hostile vibes, Nancy!
I guess it's just hard for me to believe that anybody would consider me to be that big a threat.
I should have never let you stay there by yourself.
Sally, I'm fine. I feel bad about your tool shed, though.
Who cares about the shed? It was full of junk anyway. I'm glad to be rid of it.
That's kind of the way Ranger Akers saw it, too. He showed up right after the birdwatcher did and ticketed me for burning refuse in a manner that endangered park property.
Of course.
That man is insufferable.
Emily was nice, though. She came by right afterwards and wouldn't leave until I drank the tea she made for me.
Look, Nancy, one more time. If you want to leave, just say the word and I'll come get you.
Sally, one more time. I'm fine.
Well, then promise me you'll be careful, okay?
I promise. I'll be in touch.
You better.
Okay. I feel like we should try to call all of our friends and be like, hey, somebody tried to, attempt murder on me. What do you mean, redneck?
Hello?
Bess, it's Nancy.
I know that. What's going on?
I think somebody may have deliberately put poison down Sally's well.
Yikes! What makes you think that?
The Department of Health found unusually high levels of arsenic in the water sample I sent them.
Somebody's trying to poison you with arsenic? They said that?
It's apparently not unusual to find some arsenic in well water.
So somebody could be trying to poison you, but you don't know for sure.
Right. And they may not be trying to poison anybody. They may want to contaminate the well just enough to force Sally to either go to the expense of digging a new one or forget the whole thing and leave.
And because arsenic is found naturally in well water anyway, you may never know for sure. Bummer.
Yeah, bummer.
Bye, you guys.
See ya. Bye.
Well, considering how much care he seems to have for the birds, even if he was trying to get rid of Nancy, I don't think he would go to the trouble of starting a fire that could burn down the entire forest.
Hello?
Hi, Frank.
Hey, Nancy. Hey, Joe. Pick up the phone. Joe's in the kitchen. Worked up a real appetite watching me vacuum out the car.
Vacuum out the car.
Hi, Joe. It's Nancy. What are you eating?
Sandwich. Either roast beef or really old turkey. Can't tell. Don't care. So how's life as a dog catcher?
Oh, Joe. Joe is such a goober.
Later, guys.
We'll be waiting.
Okay. So I guess nobody cares that Nancy almost died. I mean, she does face life-threatening situations on a daily basis. I mean, there's always a scene in every single Nancy Drew game where someone tries to kill her or, you know, seriously injure her to the point of, you know, to the point where she won't be able to continue her investigation. Yeah, but sorry for dying on that puzzle. I haven't played the game in a long time, so I honestly forgot some of the steps of what I was supposed to do.
Hello there. I owe you an apology. After you came up here looking for those red tails, I gave my map a closer look and realized it was more than 50 years old. Reason you can't find them is probably because their favorite nesting tree is gone. Finding that hawk's gonna be harder than I thought, so why don't you just give me back my camera and I'll take it from here. It didn't get burned up in that fire or anything, did it?
Now, I could just say this, but we all know what his answer is gonna be, so let's just say this.
You'll be happy to know that I did get a picture of a red-tail hawk.
Yeah, with the roller coaster trap.
So here's your camera back. I got all the birds.
Thank you, Nancy. Nice work. You're a credit to your generation.
Thank you, Red Knot.
Where did those gas cans come from?
I ran out of gas. So much for being prepared, huh? Well, that's all I wanted to tell you. I'm sure you've got places to go, things to see, people to pester.
See you in a while.
Shh, down a notch. Remember.
Of course, I'm sorry about that. Yeah, what are some other ones? I think in The Silent Spy, someone tries to kill her by getting her crushed in a trash compactor. Okay. I'm gonna look at the thing here. Oh yeah, I still have to tell Sally about her, I still have to tell Sally about her well water. I completely forgot. Okay, I gotta call Sally again. Honestly, one of my favorite things about the Nancy Drew games are the phone calls. Three. Eight. Nine. I would waste so much time as a kid just making phone calls to people.
Hello?
Hey, Sally, it's Nancy.
Nancy, hi, how's it going?
I'm afraid I have some bad news. I had your well water tested, and according to the health department, it contains a very high level of arsenic.
Arsenic? Somebody poisoned my well?
Maybe not. The health department is running more tests. When you bought the house, did anyone mention a problem with the well?
No. And it doesn't matter. I love that house, and I am going to live in it. If that well's bad, I'll just dig another one. At least, I will when I know for sure why bad things keep happening there. You are going to figure that out, right, Nancy?
You bet I am.
I knew I could count on you.
Talk to you later.
Bye.
I'm trying to think of other traps that Nancy has caught herself in. In other games. Thank you. I think I'm gonna call Bess and George and ask for a hint, but because I'm not sure what to do at this point in the game. One, five, two, three, five, 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 four, four, six, eight.
We're sorry. Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
Oh, did I type it in wrong? Okay. One, five, two, three, five, 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 four, four, six, eight.
Hello?
Bess, it's Nancy.
I know that. What's going on?
I could sure use a nice big hint right about now.
Be sure to check out the symbol that appears behind each dog in the clock after you turn a carving. That way, you'll know which dog in the box goes with which dog in the clock. The key is to turn each dog in a particular direction. Remember, if each dog goes with a particular season, and each season goes with a particular symbol, and each symbol goes with a particular wall, bingo.
Okay, yeah. So, check the symbol that appears behind each dog in the clock after you turn a carving. Okay. Yeah.
Bye, you guys.
Good luck, Nancy. And stay in touch.
I was trying to find something around here. Oh yeah, this over here.
Leaves that appear on a fresh spring tree make my birth different from the other three. When swans drift by on shimmering blue, I'm the one who plays in the summer dew. When autumn's call brings out the deer, it is I who howls on mornings clear. And when winter comes and birds take flight, look to me to sleep through the long gray night.
Okay. Yeah, so the next thing I have to do is the dog statue puzzle. Alright. Vetus, Iggy, Lucy, and Xander. So... Okay, I think I can figure this out. So the first dog is Vetus. And if that's the first dog, then I have to know when Vetus was born, okay. Leaves that appear on a fresh spring tree. Okay, so Vetus was born in spring, and then the next one was born in the summer. So it's spring, summer, fall, winter. I think that's how it works in real life, too. So spring, summer, fall, winter. So... I'm gonna have to do a lot of running back and forth. Okay, let's see if I've got that one right. Let's see if it appears as spring. Okay, yeah, I think that's right. Sorry, my mouse is kind of glitching right now. Okay. Swans drift summer. Okay, so I guess I have to look for swans on the second dog. Okay. It was stuck like that, so it can't be that way. Alright. Let's try that. Sorry, this puzzle might take a little bit. I want to try to figure this puzzle out on my own without looking up the answer. So I'm looking for swans on the second picture. Okay, so the second one... Okay, let's try that.
Bark.
This is such a cute cuckoo clock. Doing. So I think Lucy was born in the fall. Well, in terms of what's best for my health, I would say yes, dogs are better than cats, but I like both of them. It's just that I shouldn't really be around cats because I'm allergic to them. Okay. Lucy was born in the winter. I'm gonna look at this thing again, just to make sure I'm getting this right. So, leaves that appear on a fresh spring tree, swans drift by, autumn deer. So the third dog thing has to be showing deer, and then winter is birds, so the last one needs to be birds. I don't know what it's at right now, so I'm just gonna check. Okay, so that one's right. Okay, now no, the fourth one needs to be birds. Okay. Okay. So I'm just gonna get the fourth one.
Alright, so I'm just gonna do that and see if it did something. Okay, it's 11:30. Okay, the fourth one needs to be birds. Okay, so I got that one right. So this one needs to be deer. Yeah, so these ones, I think, need to flip-flop. So, whatever position the second one is in. So I need that. One needs to be different. Swans. Okay. So it needs a swan. That should be right, unless I got it mixed up. Okay, yeah, so... yeah, I think... that the positions of these two need to be flip-flopped. So the swans represent summer, right? Spring, summer, so it's also that one.
So I need to change that one too. Okay, so that one is right. That one is also right. First one. Ugh, this is confusing me. Okay, I need to think about this. Spring. Let's try to put the last dog. Let's try to put the last dog in the position of fall. And let's. Did it. Okay, yeah. I tried to solve that puzzle on my own, but I just couldn't do it. I can't freaking figure out what it wants from me. Oh well, I tried. Secret passage. That's so cool. Good thing I have a flashlight. There's things and stuff down here. You hear that squeaking?
Oh. William Akers? I wonder if he's related to Jeff Akers.
Interesting. Looks like we found something extremely interesting here. Hey, look. That leads to the cellar, and wow, it's all connected. I mean, of course it is, but wow. We better call Sally and tell her about this. She'll definitely want to know that she's got a secret passageway in her own house. 1, 2, 1, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 3, 8, 9. Getting a bit sleepy.
Hello?
Hey, Sally, it's Nancy.
Oh.
Nancy, hi, how's it going?
Talk to you later.
Stay in touch.
Okay, I guess I can't tell her. But hey, maybe we can go over to... Maybe we can go exploring on the boat. Let's go to Ranger Acres first to ask him about, what is it? Oh, yeah. That a possible relative of his worked for Mickey Malone.
You're back.
I found a newspaper dating back to 1927 in Sally's house. Since you're kind of an expert on the history of Moon Lake, do you mind if I ask you some questions about Mickey Malone?
Not at all.
The article mentioned that a man named William Acres used to work for Malone. Is he a relative of yours?
No. Quite a coincidence, I'll admit, but no. I am in no way related to the head flunky of some two-bit gangster and his gang of thugs.
I mean, yeah, it makes sense. I mean, just because someone has the same last name as someone, that doesn't technically mean that they're related. Some people just have the same last names.
I found this old picture in Sally's house. Do you know who these people are?
The man is Mickey Malone, I know that. I'm guessing that this is his girlfriend, Vivian Burnett, I think her name was. And judging by the year of that brand new Ford in the background, I'd say the picture was taken in 1928.
She was probably as familiar with Malone's house and his dogs as he was. Think there's any chance she's still alive?
Tell you what, Miss Drew. Why don't I go through my files and see what I can dig up on this mystery woman? I'm a busy man, but like I always say, I'm here to serve.
What happened to Acres and the rest of Malone's gang after he went to prison?
Fortunately for Moon Lake, they all left and went their separate ways.
Yeah, that sounds like it was for the better.
When and why was Malone arrested?
I'm sorry, Ms. Drew. As usual, I'm a little pressed for time. If you have more questions, why don't you sit down at the computer and peruse the Moon Lake database of fascinating factoids that I've put together?
Thanks for all your help.
Always a pleasure.
Okay. Hi, Yogi. Like I was just laying there. Okay. Well, let's see. History of Moon Lake. Famous residents. Hey, look, it's one of Malone's dogs. He was convicted of tax evasion in 1933 and sent to prison. Yeah, so he basically is like Al Capone, where the only reason he was caught was because of tax evasion. Yeah, that's he basically is an Al Capone parody where like that's the only reason he was ever caught.
Nice Junior Park Ranger pin. You must really be on Acres' good side.
I found an old newspaper in Sally's house that contained an article on Mickey Malone. It really got my curiosity going. What else can you tell me about him?
Person you should talk to is Jeff Acres. He's got this historical museum thing going out at that ranger station of his.
Guess I'll see you later.
I guess you will.
Hello, Fermented Sims. If this is your first time, welcome. Yeah. Well, actually, the phrase is technically, I gotta have some torque. But, yeah, but I've already taken care of that. That was done way, way a long time ago, so, yeah. It is a very catching phrase.
Hello?
Bess, it's Nancy.
I know that. What's going on?
I could sure use a nice big hint right about now.
Are you sure you found everything Malone left behind in that cellar?
Bye, you guys.
Don't be a stranger. Take care.
How do they know about the cellar? Nancy didn't even tell them. Questions. Questions, questions, questions. Yeah, I figured you were actually asleep, so, no harm done, no harm done. Okay, I'm just gonna go over and, oopsies. Yeah, no, I don't like that spooky music. Let's go talk to Ranger. Oh, sorry, hiccups. Let's go see if Ranger Acres has found any information on Vivian. God, I got the hiccups.
Good news. I have information on your mystery woman.
You are incredible, Ranger Acres. What did you find out?
Her name these days is Vivian Whitmore. She lives in Las Vegas, and her number is 702-555-9137.
Thanks for all your help.
That's why I'm here.
Okay. So, Fermented Sims, my name is Emily, but you can call me Emmy, and I do both gaming and drawing streams on Twitch. So, I was gonna do a drawing stream tonight, but I'm kind of moody because it's that time of the month for me, so I just didn't feel like doing any drawing, but I'll, try to do a drawing stream tomorrow night. If you make it, I'll be glad to see you. 1, 7, 02. Nine. One. Three. Seven.
If you're selling something, hang up right now.
My pronouns are also she, they.
I got an air horn in my hand that could deafen a dinosaur, and I'm not afraid to use it.
Oh, no, no, please. I'm not selling anything. Believe me. Is this Vivian Whitmore?
Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. You got exactly 5 seconds to state your business.
My name is Nancy Drew. I'm calling from Moon Lake, Pennsylvania. I just wanted to ask you some questions.
Oh, right. The Moon Lake Park Ranger said you might call. But you have to talk fast. An old friend of mine is flying in today from Florida. And when I say old, I mean old, as in 5 years older than I am. Don't bother trying to do the math, sweet stuff. You'll hurt yourself. So, that ranger fella said you found an old picture of me.
That's right. I found it in the cellar of Mickey Malone's old house on Moon Lake.
Moon Lake. Talk about your fond memories. I had a lot of fun there. Although I wasn't anywhere near as wild as most young people were back then. But I think Mickey kind of respected me for that. I was his gal for 5 years. He always kept birch beer on tap at that speakeasy of his just for me.
He had a speakeasy? Where?
It was in the basement, right there at Moon Lake. Feds never knew about it, but everybody who was anybody on the East Coast back then, actors, musicians, bankers, politicians, they knew. You weren't big time unless you'd made at least one trip to Moon Lake Mickey's.
Yeah, speakeasy. Very historical.
That's weird. I'm staying in his old house on Moon Lake, and I haven't seen any sign of a speakeasy.
Course you haven't. You're not supposed to. Only Mickey and Willie knew how to get into the speakeasy from the house. The rest of us had to go in and out the regular way, through the cemetery.
The cemetery?
There was a lock hidden in one of the tombstones in that little cemetery behind the house. You needed a key to unlock it, and when you did, stairs would appear that led to the speakeasy.
Do you have any idea how to get into Malone's speakeasy from the house?
I sure don't. That saloon was built using two main ingredients, concrete and secrecy.
Mickey always bragged
that nobody could get in unless he wanted them in, and I do believe he was right. But I'll tell you what, if you sent me that picture of me and Mickey, I'll send you my key.
The key to the tombstone? You still have it?
It's in the bottom of my jewelry box. I've come this close to throwing it out 100 times, but it's so small and the memories it brings back are so big. Well, I just couldn't. As a joke, Mickey had a tombstone made with the name of this federal agent who had it out for him inscribed on it. That's the one the key unlocks.
Well, we do know where the cemetery is. It's behind the house, so we just gotta go to the woods when we get that key.
Do you know anything about the safe that's in the cellar of his house at Moon Lake?
You must be talking about the wall safe. That was Willie's. By Willie, I mean William Akers, one of the guys who worked for Mickey.
What can you tell me about William Akers?
He was Mickey's most trusted employee. Mickey treated all his other men like dirt, but not Willie. He honestly liked Willie, respected him, trusted him implicitly.
Interesting.
It's been fun talking to you.
I know.
That's awesome. Okay, so what you have to do to get her the picture is, well, it's very simple. You just have to go back to Ranger Akers and give him the picture, and he'll mail it off to Vivian. Let me check the time. I don't think, I'm not saying that there weren't good things about the 1920s, but if I remember correctly, there was a lot of really bad historical things happening around that time. I mean, I can't remember exactly when, but wasn't weren't the 1920s, that was the time of the Great Depression, wasn't it, when the stock market crashed in 1929?
Hello again, Miss Drew. Am I in for another interrogation?
I'd like to mail this photo to the woman in Las Vegas. Can you do that for me?
As always, I'm here to serve, Ms. Drew. Just give it to me and I'll take care of it. I'm sure she'll be very pleased to get this back.
Thanks for all your help.
Not a problem.
Okay, yeah. So, I think if memory serves me correctly, first there was the stock market crash and then afterwards was the Great Depression. So, yeah. One thing just led to another. But yeah, I think there was, I'm pretty sure there was still a lot of crazy stuff happening in the 1920s. I wish I could remember what generation that is, because obviously I'm a Generation Z person. I was born in 2000, and my youngest sister, who is 4 years old, she would be a Generation Alpha. Okay. Well, I think I'm gonna go upstairs, go to sleep, do it again. And, it's pretty much midnight at this point, so I'm going to save. I'd argue that people are still dumbasses now. They're just a different kind of dumbass. Dumbass, the 50th edition. Alright, night, Sir Simeon. I'll see you guys hopefully tomorrow for a drawing stream.